No, ma'am. Propane will not freeze. Good news, Buck. We can get propane to the nursing homes by diverting it away from the Museum of Modern Art. If anyone asks, it was a tough choice.
Uh-huh. That's why your dad's one of the greats. Just watch and learn, son. Maybe someday you'll be sitting in that seat.
Then where would he sit?
Way things are going, he'll be in the boss's chair.
Oh, no, sir. I'll just keep the chair I have and wheel it over to your desk when the time comes.
Whew! I'm beat. I think I'm going to call it a day. Just got to finish up my paperwork. There, finished.
Hey, Dad, how come I never got a Strickland calendar?
That's not for you, Bobby. You're not old enough.
Well, hello, Miss November. You be careful, that's flammable.
Bobby, why don't you go on outside and make snow angels?
Okay.
Ooh, hey, speaking of angels, look at the wings on this piece of chicken, would you?
Well, she certainly is attractive, sir, but I'm not sure that's an appropriate way to be talking about our cleaning lady.
Merry Christmas! I see your stockings are sure hung with care.
Buck?
God dang it, I'm having an infarction. Could you ladies step outside for a minute, please? I got a shot coming, and it's just rude, you know, to make two such pretty gals stare at my bare backside. All right, now that the skirts are out in the hallway, we can get down to business.
Our employee of the month is Hank Hill. Congratulations, Hank. That's 41 times in a row.
Thank you, sir. I wish you could see the expression on my face.
Okie doke.
But you can't.
Hey, Hank, how's your new hire doing?
Oh, I just think he's gonna work out great, sir.
Yeah, well, I could have sworn I saw him over by the trucks puking his guts out.
Well, he's pretty excited about working in propane, sir. But once he sells his first grill, those highs and lows will smooth out.
Well, I hope they do. Remember, Hank, he's wearing the name Strickland over his man teat.
Oh, Mr. Strickland's wife is beautiful.
That's not his wife. That's Debbie from work. Pretty girl like that should have been able to get a date. Strickland. The S stands for service. The T is for trust. R is for reliability. Now, the I stands for...
Jackass!
No. It's for integrity. That's not even the right letter.
That's Mrs. Strickland. This ought to be good.
Now, Miss Liz, just calm down here. We're in public.
You are in public with this little bimbo in front of half our Christmas card list. Are those my mother's earrings?
C is for, compassion.
I want you out of the house.
Yeah, but
and out of the lake house.
Out of the lake house?
I'm sorry I stole your thunder, Hank. Please, start over.
Now where was I?
D for done.
Now we gotta move fast. Hank, give me whatever cash you got. Uh-huh, son. You just bought yourself a barbecue joint.
I hereby transfer 100% ownership of Sugarfoot's barbecue to Hank Hill.
Yeah, that's right. And after my divorce is final, you'll therefore transfer 100% ownership back to me. And Miss Liz can't have half of what I don't own, you see. You saw me, don't you?
Sir, I don't like to ask personal questions, but are you okay?
My wife threw me out.
What?
Yeah, I had Donna over at the house. The old crow found us in flagrante on the credenzi. It's all over. She said she could handle my drinking binges and my gambling and even turn a blind eye to my extramarital escapades, but not when they happen all at once. And on her birthday, oh, I don't know what to do anymore, Hank.
There, sir.
Hey, Uncle Hank, Aunt Peggy! Look who I saved!
Hallelujah!
Oh,
Good Lord! What the hell is going on here?
A private Bible study class.
Praise the Lord!
Luann, Platter Family Conference on the patio. Ahara. Is he hitting on you? Is he coming on to you? Has he put his hands on you? What has he done to you?
Nothing, Aunt Peggy. I found him at the church, and he was so sad and lost. I told him about the Word of God, and he volunteered me to be his private Bible tutor.
Me? A Bible tutor?
You know, Luann, it's awful hot out here. Maybe next week we could study in the pool.
Bible class in the pool? Like a baptism?
Yeah,
I'll bring my swimsuit.
So, that's why it's better to be a little bird sitting in heaven than to be the biggest,
toughest grizzly bear in hell.
Do you know what I mean?
Yes.
Yay! Fellowship hug!
Amen to that.
Okay, the thing about camels going through the eye of a needle, it's not good for the camels. So you can understand why it's not good to be rich.
Totally.
I'm as good as broke. I'm losing everything in the divorce.
Hey, is this a Bible study in the pool class?
Principal Moss?
Prattley? Oh, Ruth the poop.
You got my flyer.
We sure did, Teach. And that picture does not do you justice.
Oh, dang, I forgot my Bible. I'll just kind of look off yours here, Miss Luann.
Okay, but next time you'd better remember. Remembering-ness is next to holiness.
Whoa. Hold on here. Then you gonna find out.
Pajamas?
Yeah! Hank was right all along. Dang it, what can't be fun. We're gonna have us an all-night slumber party.
I gotta bust out of here, Hank. You don't know this, but I've been locked up before.
You're not locked up. You're just kind of being held hostage. After the game's over, we'll get inventory done and get the heck out of here.
Popcorn's in the microwave. What word we on?
Pomegranate. And Joe Jack's narrowed it down to three definitions.
Pomegranate. What a cheerleader cheers with. A fruit with juicy seeds? Or a sack of dirt you hit yourself on the head with? That one, I guess.
Joe Jack, you stink at dictionary. A pomegranate's a fruit boy fruit. A delicious fruit. That's your new nickname, Pomegranate.
Can we get to work? It's my husband's birthday for another 10 minutes. I just want to get home.
Ah, Enrique, you're not the wet blanket anymore. She is.
Hank! I can't take this anymore.
Just hold on, Enrique. This can't go on forever. Oh, God. He's got risk.
Look alive, Enrique. Kamchatka is calling Japan out.
Maybe that should be our cue to call it a night, sir. I'll just guesstimate the number of meat thermometers.
What's the matter with you people? Now, I try to make working in a crummy propanery fun, and, well, plainly, I need to soak a bunch more wet blankets.
I won't wear the blanket again, honey. I swear I won't.
There's no reason to do any of this junk.
When he comes back, I say we throw a blanket over his head and do what feels right.
Sure, that might make us all feel better in the short term, but the moment he regains consciousness, we're right back where we started.
Truth or dare, Enrique. Ever kill anyone?
No!
Darn, I thought you were going to take a dare. I was going to blindfold you and make you sniff the mystery foot. Strickland propane, it's a gas, gas, gas.
Do you know who you knocked down? The chairman of the membership committee. Yeah, that's right, Corky Raywood. Oh, I'd be wetting myself too right now if I were you. Sir, your son was involved in an incident near Green Number 6. A club member was incapacitated due to ice blocking. Your son's services as a caddy have been terminated.
Oh, God, Bobby. Mr. Strickland is my boss. He put his reputation on the line to get you this job. Corky Raywood may have a deep thigh bruise, but the real victim here is Mr. Strickland. You owe that man an apology. I'll wait out here.
I'm really sorry, sir. I don't know if you've ever ridden a block of ice before.
Well, I married Miss Liz, didn't I? Now, don't you worry, Bobby. I'll take care of this.
But that security guy said I was fired.
Then that security guard's fired.
Oh, no, please.
Two ladies fired. Oh, sorry, Bobby. I was making a hot toddy before you showed up. You want a hot toddy? Hot toddy will calm your nerves.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Miss Liz! Two hot toddies! We're going to toast your new job as my personal caddy. Now tell me, Bobby, you really knocked that some bitch on his ass? You know he tried to get me kicked out of the club for throwing my putt at his wife? No one sneezes when Buck Strickland's about to putt. Except for Buck Strickland.